تبرج and mixing of the sexes. The one who is satisfied with this latter instinct must sacrifice the first one in order to silence the voice of the innate ghira in his heart in return for the so-called enjoyment of tabarruj and mixing. And from this we understand that tabarruj is a sign of corruption of fitra, lack of bashfulness, ghira, and insensitivity. 13. Tabarruj is a door to widespread evil. Anyone who carefully examines the Islamic texts from the Quran and authentic Sunnah and the lessons of history becomes convinced about the evils of tabarruj and its harm, both on religious and worldly matters, especially when it is associated with the mixing of sexes. Some of its underlying consequences are the competition among the displaying women in showing off their beauty. The competition amongst the displaying women in showing off their beauty. This is seduction. And it leads to the spoiling of morality and leaves women as merchandise articles exhibited for anyone to look at. Secondly, the corruption of the morality of men, especially the youth and those in adolescence. It pushes them to commit various kinds of sins. You may have seen teenage kids on the corners of many streets in Europe and in North America and in other parts of the world roaming around, smoking to get high, half naked and on drugs, looking to engage in sexual relationships. Why? What happened? Many try to hide from the hard facts. Their drive for lust or the drive for lust and materialistic life became the objective of the new generations. The Pepsi, Michael, MTV, Jackson generations, the result, AIDS and other sexually transmitted diseases. Thirdly, the destruction of family ties and causing a lack of trust between family members and the spread of divorce. This is from the consequences of tabarruj. Fourthly, the commercial abuse of women in the world of advertisement, entertainment and other areas as well. Fifthly, doing harm to women by declaring their ill intentions and evil conscience, thus rendering her vulnerable to harm by the wicked and the insolent. The spread of diseases. 6. The Prophet ﷺ said, لم تظهر الفاحشة في قوم قط حتى يعلنوا بها إلا فشى فيهم الطاعون والأوجاع التي لم تكن في أسلافهم الذين مضوا. Sins did not spread in any particular nation until they openly conducted, and as a result, plague and other illnesses that were not present among their predecessors became widespread amongst them. Seventh, facilities or facilitates the sin of zina, fornication by the eye. The Prophet ﷺ said, "العينانِ زِنَاهُمَا النَّظَر." The adultery of the eyes is the lustful look. And this is in Sahih Muslim. Eighthly, tabarruj makes it difficult to lower the gaze. Ninthly, justifiably brings down Allah's punishment. The punishment of Allah is more severe than atomic bombs and earthquakes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Isra 17:16, وَإِذَا أَرَدْنَا أَن نُهْلِكَ قَرْيَةً أَمَرْنَا مُتْرَفِيهَا فَفَسَقُوا فِيهَا حق عليها القول فدمرناها تدميرا. And when we decide to destroy a town, a population, we first send a definite order to obey Allah and be righteous to those among them, for we first increase in number those of its population. who are given the good things in this life, then they transgress therein, and thus the word of torment is justified against it or them, then we destroy it with complete destruction. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إن الناس إذا رأوا المنكر فلم يغيروه أوشك أن يعمهم أو أن يعمهم الله بعذاب. When people see wrong or evil and they don't change it, then it is imminent that the punishment of Allah will fall upon them. And this is reported by Abu Dawood and others. These are the matters related to tabarruj and the description of tabarruj and the consequences and the evil of tabarruj. Inshallah, in the next talk, we will talk about the obligatory conditions for an Islamic hijab. That will be the topic for tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa sallallahu ala Muhammadin, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi.